Well, you came out of the Bahamas with a pretty good feeling. I mean, just talk about the game you had down there in that first game and just the overall what the team accomplished.
It's a great accomplishment to actually win, you know, one of our first tournaments and have the experience of actually getting a glimpse of what a championship feels like. So it was a great experience. I mean, the first game, I didn't know it was going to come like that, but it happened. And I'm just grateful to God I had that chance to actually have a breakout game and kind of get back in the flow of how I normally play.
You guys are playing so well and you're winning those games like that. I mean, can you get much out of it, or can you be self-critical at any point through that two-game process?
I think we're always self-critical. I mean, even with the coaches, they always want us to be better. So I think that when we do get better, we look at the little things. I think that's the biggest thing that they've been focused on this year is paying attention to detail and actually being able to do the little things to get out there and play. Because when we do that, things become easier for us and it makes us a better team as a whole.
The way Ariel's played in the way you kind of lit it up down there, I mean, the backcourt, I mean, it's got to be in a pretty good frame of mind right now.
I think we are. I mean, it was a good test at first, but I feel like in these next couple of games against good teams, I feel like it's going to be an even bigger test. So I'm just waiting to see what happens. And I think, you know, so far, Ariel's done an amazing job as a point guard. She's really stepping up as a leader, and she's leading us the right way. So I'm really excited.
Texas is I'm sorry. Go ahead.
What's the biggest difference you see in Ariel this year versus maybe their first couple seasons?
She's more talkative. The Ariel that I know is very homesick. She didn't really, you know, want to communicate with anybody. But, you know, she's grown. She's blossomed into an amazing leader. And I think that that's something that Pat has always looked for in her, as well as something that Holly has looked for in her.
When did you start to notice the difference?
Her sophomore year. That's when I really started to realize it, because she started to communicate a lot more. She was communicating with the coaches more. She was getting involved with everybody else. So I knew that from then on she was going to be a great leader.
Texas coming in here. I mean, I know they're not ranked, but always seems to be a bit of tradition, maybe legacy with Pat and Jody. What does that game and that series kind of mean to you guys?
I mean, it's always a big game against Texas, and whenever they play here, they always want to play their best and give their 110%. But I think that it's just like any other game. We have to come in, and we know they're going to try to. They beat Texas A&M a couple games ago, so. I think it's just one thing. We got to take one game at a time, play Tennessee basketball, and not play down to their level. Even though they are ranked, we can't take them lightly. We have to treat it as any other game.
Yeah, the fact that they're not ranked, though, I mean, with Jody having coached there for so long and Pat and Jody had that sort of rivalry going, I mean, does this game stand out, even though they're not ranked, maybe a little bit more than other games do?
I think it does. I think it does stand out because it is a very good competition game. Texas has a great team. You know, they have Chastity Pizzell, who is like probably one of the better scorers in the country. So it's just something that we got to look forward to. I mean, it's just a test to see how well we handle certain situations, and we're going to see how well we adjust to their intensity.
The start you guys have had, 7-8, I've lost track now, but the fact that you haven't had a misstep yet, I mean, how good is that, and what kind of mindset and confidence does that give you going into the rest of December?
It's a good experience. I mean, it's for us to be 7-0, you know, in the beginning, you know, not losing our first game, learning from last year, and just going in and playing hard. It's just a great experience. I mean, I'm glad that we're 7-0 right now. It does give us a lot of confidence, but we're never going to be too satisfied. There's always work to be done, and we got to take things and pay attention to the little details.
So tell me you're not thinking about the Stanford game, just a little bit going out there?
I'm not. I'm just taking it one game at a time in order for us to get there. And I just think, like I said, I don't like to think too far ahead, because you never know what the future holds. So I just want to take one game at a time, learn from the mistakes that we make in games, you know, until then. And then once we get to that time, we'll see what happens.
Meighan, offensively, when you look at your guys' game, you're coming off a really good game. How, when you guys analyze how things are going on that end of the floor, what do you like and where do you think you guys can get better?
I feel like offensively, like with our rebounding, I feel like our rebounding has been good, but I feel like it can get better. Our ball movement, like when other teams are playing us in a zone and actually moving and not being stagnant on offense, I feel like it's something that we definitely need to work on. But I feel like other than that, our offense has been very good. I mean, it hasn't been dictating our defense. Our defense has been dictating our offense.
Coming off your big game in the Bahamas, I just want to know, was looking out the window kind of, did that refresh you a little bit, maybe relax you and get you ready to knock down some shots?
A little bit. I mean, I had a little moment to reflect about what I wanted to do and what I expected of myself for that game and just for the tournament itself. And I just wanted to give my 110% for the team.
Did you have a good time in the Bahamas?
I did. It was fun. It was finally good to have some warm weather.
Thank you.